Met een verlies van 1 miljard rand weens diefstal die afgelopen 3 jaar, sê minister Fikile Mbalula, het is tijd om zaken om te keren. Maar hoewel die diefstal en schade aan infrastructuur voor allemaal duidelijk is, sê die minister, daar is een administratieve crisis waarin ook aandag gegee moet word.
Criminals have been in charge here. They've been running a show and then they've been aided by some of the employees inside. The people who were appointed here were appointed irregularly. And it meant that if we had to take a decision against those companies, we needed to have a contingency plan.
Diegene wat daarvan beskuldig word, het ontken. Hulle beweer dat Prasa nie verantwoordelikheid wil neem nie.
Makhosini Nkosi must stop lying to the public saying these security officers are the ones who are stealing and the companies also they were involved. That is a pure lie. We do have footages, photos, whereby Prasa officials themselves are the ones who are stealing.
Volgens Prasa se woordvoerder het die spooragentskap echter die verlies van 'n miljard rand gelei terwyl die beskuldigdes aan diens was.
Whilst they were on duty, Prasa suffered losses to the tune of about a billion rands for the 3 years up to 2019. And we couldn't go when we're recruiting now, our own protection officers use the principle of hire one, hire all.
As gevolg van die beëindiging van die sekuriteitskontrakte is baie van diegene wat by die sekuriteitsmaatskappye in diens was, al weke sonder werk.
From July, they start coming with their problems. Who are spending more than 3 months without pay? How we can survive without pay?
Die departement wil die stelsel opruim wat daartoe gelei het dat Prasa miljoene verloor het.
There will be no mercy for criminals who think they can continue stealing and vandalizing public assets with impunity.
Prasa sê dit het verskeie sake vir vervolging op aanklag van ekonomiese sabotasie gemaak.